Hello Space Cats and welcome back to my channel. In 1983, the European Space Agency launched its first X-ray space satellite, Exosat. But just a year previous to this, a proposal was made to the agency for a multi-mirror X-ray space telescope. And by 1985, serious work was put into materializing this new mission, which would eventually become what we know as today as XMM-Newton. Just in time too, since by 1986, Exosat had reached the end of its mission. This week, XMM-Newton will have been flying for over 20 years. So in this week's video, I'll be talking everything about this wonderful mission. The name XMM stands for X-ray Multi-Mirror. Since XMM-Newton is not just one telescope, but it is in fact three X-ray telescopes. Each one of them are made up of 58 wafer fin mirrors. The mirrors are coated in gold. These cylindrical mirrors are nested within one another, and this allows the very high energy X-rays to lightly graze across the surface of the mirrors and then focus onto the detectors. They really are huge though. Each one weighs in about 420 kilograms. That's approximately the weight of a cow. The Newton in XMM-Newton is an honor to Sir Isaac Newton, who, besides having an apple fall on his head and formulating the theory of gravity, which is typically what he's most well known for, he also invented spectroscopy. XMM-Newton was designed to take high-quality spectroscopy of faint X-ray-emitting astronomical sources, measuring the intensity of the X-rays as a function of their wavelength. This spectra is what allows us to measure the composition, the temperature, and the velocity of the X-ray sources. Additionally, XMM was designed to observe a very large area on the sky. XMM has a field of view of 30 arc minutes, which is about the same size as the moon is on the sky. Due to the grazing incidence of the X-rays and the reflectivity of the mirrors, however, the geometrical area of the telescope is reduced to an effective area. This is typically going to vary with the wavelength of the X-ray photons. This parameter is what makes a good and what we call a high sensitivity X-ray telescope. For XMM, the effective area is 4,650 centimeters squared, which is 9 times larger than NASA's Chandra telescope. Much of XMM's design is based upon lessons learned from the previous X-ray telescope, Exosat. It lives in a highly eccentric orbit around the Earth, reaching a third of the way to the Moon, giving it 48 hours of uninterrupted observations. And this is important to look for things like clusters of galaxies, which easily require 10 hours or more of observation time. Having all the instruments on board work at the same time, working simultaneously, is also very important in making XMM an efficient telescope. In addition to the three X-ray telescopes on board, XMM has an optical monitor, and this simultaneously observes the field that it's looking at in UV and optical light. It also has two star trackers on board to help it navigate on the sky, and in fact, the pointing accuracy of XMM is pretty incredible, 0.25 arc seconds in 10 seconds. That's equivalent to trying to focus on a grain of salt on the ground while standing on top of the Eiffel Tower. The thing that I find most impressive about XMM-Newton is that it was launched on the 10th of December 1999 with a life expectancy of just 10 years. But here we are 20 years later and XMM is still going strong. So what gives? XMM was built to have enough fuel to run until at least 2020. But with some very clever tricks, XMM now has enough fuel to run until at least 2030. One of these tricks is the repurposing of reaction wheels. And for those of you who don't know, reaction wheels control the attitude and orbit of a spacecraft. XMM has three of these that are in operation, and a fourth that was a spare. It was a backup in case any of the others broke. They spin at a very certain speed, and any changes to the speed causes the transfer of angular momentum from the wheels to the spacecraft, causing it to move. The engineers realized that the amount of angular momentum stored in the reaction wheels is proportional to the amount of fuel that was used by the spacecraft. So by moving from three reaction wheels that were active to four, they were able to reduce the amount of angular momentum stored and more than halve the fuel consumption of the spacecraft. The reaction wheels are great for slowing the telescope, but they're not really built for any bigger maneuvers, for like moving the spacecraft around. For that, you need thrust firing, which means that you also need to burn some fuel. And this needs to happen about once per day. The fuel in XMM is distributed across four tanks, and the main tank will run out of fuel first. By heating the other tanks, they can evaporate the fuel and then recondensate the fuel back down, redistributing it more evenly between all the different tanks. No one has ever done this before, so the scientists are doing all the simulations to make sure that this is a success. But with it, XMM will be given another extra few years of life. Currently, XMM-Newton is projected to be able to continue operations beyond 2030. But let's hope it makes it to overlap Athena, ESA's upcoming X-ray mission, and also XMM's successor, which has a planned launch date of 2031. Thanks so much for watching this week's video. Next week, I'll be back for another special of XMM-Newton. It's gonna be a bit different from my usual format, so make sure you tune in for that. And in the meanwhile, if you enjoyed my video, don't forget to leave me a like, share, and subscribe.